In this tutorial, we're going to look at some of the features in the edit mode of ACDSee. When we're finished, we will easily turn this image into this image. I'll start with a JPEG image and click on the edit mode to open the image for editing. On the right side, I have the layers pane. On the left side, I have the filter menu pane. Editing starts with the image in layer 1 of the layers pane. There are two kinds of operations you can perform in edit mode. You can apply filters from the filter menu, and you can add adjustment layers from the adjustment layers menu. I frequently begin my editing by duplicating the initial layer. Since edits will be performed on the selected layer, having the original layer makes it easy to make multiple different kinds of edits conveniently. You can use multiple layers much like the snapshots in develop mode. I have the histogram pane turned on so you can see changes as we use the edit tools. I'll rename the layer to indicate the type of filter I'm using. This is just for reference, since the name doesn't affect what you do to the layer. Before adjusting exposure, be sure you have the layer selected you want to filter. I'll select Light EQ from the Filters menu. I only want the far side of the river brightened, so I'll use a graduated mask. In edit mode, masks are available in all the filters where they are appropriate to be used. I can adjust the size, rotation, and centering by using the handles of the mask. I'll adjust exposure by adding some fill light to bring out the shadow areas. If the fill light is not sufficient, I could add some brightening. I can also control the effect by adjusting the opacity. Reducing the opacity reduces the effect of the filter. Notice the Show Previous button at the bottom of the pane. Clicking that shows the previously applied filter. Since no filter has been applied, clicking the button will only show the unedited image. I can click Done to save the adjustments to the current layer and continue editing this image, or I can click Cancel to throw away any changes made with the current filter. I will click Done to exit this filter and save the adjustments to the current layer. Notice the Show Previous has been replaced with Show Saved. If I click the Show Saved button, we see the original image, since we haven't saved the edits to a file. We can also see the original image just by hiding the layer we have edited. Since layer 1 is the original image, and blending mode is normal, the upper image layer completely overlays the layers below. Other blending modes are available and may produce useful results, but also may produce odd results. You can experiment with these to see how they behave. I'm going to click Done so we can see what happens when we are finished with this edit. We get the options Save As, Discard, or Cancel. Save As will allow us to save the image. Discard will throw away all changes, returning to the original. Cancel will return to editing. I'll choose Save As and use the ACDSee format. Notice that we have the new ACDSee image and still have the original JPEG image. Also notice that neither image indicates that it has been developed or edited. This is because the original image has not been changed and the ACDSee image is a new original. Now let's edit the file we saved as the ACDSee file. The ACDSee file type saved the layers as we had adjusted them. However, we can't return to the exposure filter and modify the settings we used. When I select the Light EQ mode for the previously edited layer, note that the controls are all at the default level. I'll make another adjustment and we'll save the ACDSee file again. This time when I click Save, I am allowed to save the file without changing the name. Notice that the saved file now shows the icon showing it had been edited. I'll refresh the file list by clicking on the refresh icon. Notice the added folder. Let's look in that. The previous ACDSee file is there, since it was an original file. The new ACDSee file is an edited version. ACDSee always keeps the originals. If we did process restore original, we would get the first saved ACDSee file, but not the original JPEG file. This is because the ACDSee version was a new original. We still have the original JPEG file, so it was not necessary to save an additional copy. It will probably take a little time to get comfortable with the process. Also, be aware that deleting the edited ACDSee file will also delete the original ACDSee file. If you want to keep the original ACDSee file, do Process Restore Original to return to the original ACDSee file. To show this, we'll verify that the original ACDSee file is in Originals. Now, I'll delete the edited ACDSee file. Now, checking for the original, it has been deleted too. Using filters on layers is a powerful editing method. However, the drawback we just saw was that you can't return to the filter adjustments after saving the changes, even when saving to the ACDSee format. Let's look at another way of adjusting the image by using adjustment layers. Since we don't modify the image layer when using adjustment layers, I won't make a copy of the original layer. However, if you use both filters and adjustment layers, you might want to make a duplicate for use with the filters. Let's start with the Light EQ adjustment layer. When you click an adjustment layer, you get a new layer above the currently selected layer. The layer has a mask that controls the area of the image layer below that will be adjusted. A white mask allows everything in the lower layer to be affected. A black mask prevents any effect on the lower layer. I'll brighten the image by sliding the brighten control. Notice that the entire image is brightened. Now if I invert the mask, none of the image is affected. With the Light EQ adjustment layer selected and the mask selected, I will erase some of the black. Looking at the mask shows areas of white which allow the adjustment to affect the layer below. By adjusting the opacity of the layer, we can adjust the amount of the effect. By clicking on the layer rather than the mask, we can change brighten and darken sliders. By clicking on the mask, we can adjust the feathering to get smoother transitions in the adjustment areas. By clicking Disable Mask, we can see what the image is like without the mask. By clicking the Invert button, we can invert the area affected by the adjustment. Sometimes you might want to treat the inverse of a mask differently. This is easily done by adding another adjustment layer, copying the previous mask, and pasting as a mask on the new layer. I will adjust the curves to change the bottom part of the image. Now let's duplicate the image layer. Since both image layers are the same, turning one or the other off doesn't change the output. However, each filter layer has a clipping icon. Turning on clipping makes the adjustment apply only to the nearest image layer below. If I turn on the clipping option on the adjustment layers, the adjustments only apply to the nearest image layer below. If I hide the top image layer, we see the bottom image layer without any changes, since clipping makes the adjustments only apply to the nearest image below the adjustments. We've looked at a few tools and techniques for using the edit mode of ACDSee. Now let's look at making a better image from the cabin image. While this is an icon RAW file, ACDSee handles it in a similarly safe way as other file formats. The image was shot on a heavily overcast day in early spring, making the cabin and the grass dark and the sky rather disappointing. I guess I wasn't paying close attention to the level because the horizon is a bit tilted. I'll first make a copy of the initial layer, as I normally do. My first edit will be to straighten the image. This is done with a filter and will apply to the entire image, not just the currently selected layer. I can rotate the image manually, or I can draw a vertical line or a horizontal line to straighten the image. Clicking Done will apply the filter. Next, I'll use layers to adjust the image. I'll use Light EQ to make the sky a little stormier. Since I want to adjust only the sky with this layer, I'll invert the mask and use the eraser to erase black to white, using about 25 for opacity. Since the eraser will erase foreground color to background color, we want the background color to be white. We can swap the colors by clicking the double arrow. Since my next adjustment will be to lighten the bottom of the image, I'll copy the Light EQ layer and invert the mask and adjust to make the grass and cabin brighter. Next, I'll use clarity to make the image a little sharper, bringing out the tree limbs. Now, I'll use vibrance to brighten up the image. We can also add masks directly to the image layers. I'll add a mask to the copy of layer 1. I want to use this to make the clouds even more menacing. I copy the mask from the first light EQ layer and paste it as mask to copy of layer 1. Then I'll use the blending mode for the copy and set it to overlay. This will increase the contrast of the clouds. I hope this video has provided some help in using the edit mode of ACDSee. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe. I'll try to provide additional videos with more focused techniques in the future. Thank you for viewing.